Once again, good afternoon, everyone. We're bringing you Mat Time action from the Victoria Pavilion in Calgary. And in the ring, Gino Bob Morella and John Foti. This one is going to go 10 minutes. And this is for a pot that has gradually been building up. A pot that Morella will put up of a total of $650. John Foti throws 50 bucks into the pot for this opportunity on Mat Time to try and take the money away. And in case you haven't heard it before, we might point out that anybody, amateur, professional, otherwise, I don't know what else there is, can take on Mr. Morella. Oh, look at that. And if they can pin him in 10 minutes, that 650 bucks could be theirs, provided Foti doesn't walk away with it here this morning. John Foti, working with Gino Bob Morella. Foti has held in the past the Canadian Heavyweight Championship. Morella, you're probably well aware, is one of the all-time amateur greats of the United States in both Olympic, European competition and so forth, and is doing a solid job of it. There's a neat bit of work. He's doing a solid job as a pro. We have an excellent crowd on hand here as we film this Mat Time series at the Victoria Pavilion. Okay, they break. There's a neat takedown. And don't forget, he's taking down 280 pounds of it. Neat takedown by Foti. Ooh! Certainly points out that this wrestling is a combination of strength and leverage. So that a good smaller man like Foti, when I say smaller, he weighs about 230, you know, he can handle himself against a big man. They go into the far side. Referee is Tor Morgan. We had some wild goings on last night between Ricky Waldo and that gentleman, and I use the term loosely, Bulldog Brower. Look at that, there's a full Nelson. Look at that. The full Nelson, he just took it out of there. Nice play, Morella. We had one amateur going into the ring against Morella. Cowboy Johnny Sinclair. He lasted about 3.5 minutes, as I recall. Bang! John Foti, one of the all-time popular ring idols of Canada. Now, Morella has great power, and you can see it. Well, actually, from our camera location, it'd be difficult to see, but with one arm, he was doing what Foti was doing with two, and he got out of the hole. Now has the arm bar, Mr. Foti, but here, look out, something's got to give. Look out, Nelly. Oh!
$150 in this pot now, Ed.
Stu Hart, president of the Foothills Athletic Club, pointing out that, as we mentioned, there's $650 riding here. And, no, sir.
The money looks pretty safe right at the moment, doesn't it?
I would say so. John is having trouble controlling this big man. 5 minutes has gone in the match. Foti is having trouble. Look out. bang. Do it again. Oh, he got him with a beautiful drop kick. Hits him again, and out he goes. Well, speak of the devil, Stu Hart. We were saying John was having his troubles, and all of a sudden, bang. I don't know whether he's going to get out of there. Of course, I believe the rules are the man has to be pinned, don't he?
Yes, the man has to be pinned.
He has to be pinned. So the $650 will not count. Tom Morgan counted him out outside the ring. So I guess that's going to be it. John Foti, the winner, with a couple of surprise drop kicks, very well executed.
Did that go?
Went about 5 minutes.
About 5 minutes, eh?
Okay, we'll get Ricky Waldo over here to say a few words.
Gino won the match, but he didn't win the pot.
No, we were just discussing that, Gino, and that is a fact. It, of course, has been pointed out in the past that, whoops, I'm going to take off here. Let's get up into the ring, man, shall we? It's been pointed out in the past that it has to be a pinfall. Otherwise, the money doesn't change hands. Let's get Ricky Waldo up here. Ricky Waldo, as I mentioned, was involved last night in a real pure sixer with this Bulldog Brower. And this has to be one of the roughest fights I've seen in a long time. You're getting a round of applause, Ricky.
Yeah, it was a pretty rough match last night. And I felt as though that I had the advantage most of the match there, but somehow you can always just do one slip and you lose track of everything, you know? And I'm very well interested in having a rematch because I feel as though that I can perform much better than that. I can more or less can take care of the character because I don't think you have the ability to wrestle. He's just wild and weird and that's about all.
Well, you know, this is interesting, Stu, too. If I might just mention, you were away at the time. But as Ricky came into the ring, he got a good round of applause from around ringside here. And this is one of the real pet hates of the fans in this area. But I guess they just hate Brower a little more.
Well, it did prove to me last night that the big man can be stood up to. And Waldo stood up to him every inch of the way. In fact, up to the point where Waldo got nailed there at the last. I think Waldo had the better of the match on points, and he was just as tough as the big fella was, and he backed the big boy up out the around that ring pretty good.
Well, I certainly have to agree that this fella Waldo put on a great display in controlling this man Brower. What about the rematch situation?
Well, I'm going to have had a lot of calls from other boys wanting a match with the big fellow, and I'm there's several that I've got in mind, so I'm going to just I'm not going to make my mind up right now, just I'm going to see how things shape up, and there's several that could give Brower a very good match. For instance, there's Ricky Waldo, there's Timmy Gehagan, there's Mighty Ursa, the big Gino Morello, there's even John Foti here now that have to be contended with.
Right. Well, Ricky, we'll see what gives.
What I'd like to do is have the fans maybe give me some views on it, and if they wanted, they could phone my house and give me a call on who they might like to see tackle this man.
Do I dare give out your phone number?
Yeah, you
can. CH92143. Okay, write that down. John?
I'd just like to say, Ed, that I don't want these people to think that Gino Morella is not one of the greatest in the business today. He most certainly is. I'd like the people to know that although I haven't pinned him, I did beat him, even though I had to drop kick him out of the ring to do so. But now, the people should understand this, that a smaller man can beat a big man, and that jackpot gets bigger every week. And if I keep on wrestling Morella enough times, I may yet beat him and pin him right here in the middle of the ring.
That'd be nice. You could use the 650 clams, too, eh?
Nice little pot right now.
Okay, you know, what do we have in here?
We have a bunch of our top amateurs of the city here, and Harold can tell you just what he has here.
Okay, Harold, maybe the camera can take a look at some of these youngsters behind us. Harold, tell us about your boys. These are amateur performers.
Why they're going to perform tonight in the provincial wrestling championships at 7:30. There'll be boys from Edmonton to compete with them, and Lethbridge and Turner Valley and anywhere in the province.
Harold, where would that be held? At the Y?
At the YMCA, yes.
The YMCA, eh? Are you guys all in shape and ready? Are you? Okay, thank you very much. And that's 7:30 at the YMCA tonight. Harold Evans, of course, is noted as one of the all-time great amateur performers. And I'm sure he could tackle a man three times his size and take care of him. He's a dandy, this one.
Yes, I'm kind of relieved we haven't got the great Bulldog with us this morning.
No,
I overslept or something.
That's just as well, I think. We've probably had enough of the Bulldog shenanigans. Gene Murphy in the ring against that fine Canadian, Ken Lorimer, okay?
He's got a climate that he's really shown some wrestling.
Yeah, he started somewhat slowly, a head scissors there. However, as you say, I think he's starting to move now.
He kind of got clobbered by that Brown. I think he kind of knocked him off to a bad start, but he's certainly making a wonderful comeback now.
Look out! Bang! And down he goes!
When he came in here, he had a very high rating from Europe. They said he was one of the top wrestlers in Europe at the time, and when I saw him wrestle Brown, I thought, well, maybe... the rest is not so good over there, but he's showing a lot of class right now, isn't he?
He is indeed. He's coming along real well. And he has competed against some of the world's great wrestlers. I think primarily of a fellow like Dara Singh of India, recognized as the Asian champion and sort of a legend in wrestling. Ken Lorimer, hailing from Vancouver, former Calgarian. Man, he's holding that hammerlock on Murphy, isn't he? He can't get out of it. Look out now. Down it goes again, and he's still got it. He's still got it. Well, a man from down under, Gene Murphy, is having trouble here. At the moment, with this one hammerlock that Lorimer has slapped on him extremely effectively. Look out. He's still got it! A man from down under, maybe down in the dumps, too, you know? A little frustrating. He's done everything possible to break out of that thing and couldn't do it. So they finally broke the hold. Just recognizing the fact that this is merely a workout session. Pressure being applied by Lorimer. He's got an Indian deathlock on him. He's got an Indian deathlock. Wraps himself in those two legs. Applies the pressure. And the referee says, oh, let's take it cool, Ken. Let's not do it. That Indian deathlock is murder. On the legs, I saw Chief Thunderbird incapacitated after a match with Al Mills with that hold. Nice hold. Flying head scissors by Lorimer. This Lorimer is developing a very solid following. I think, too, particularly among the younger set, they recognize him as one of the younger men of the game, of course. Look at those takedowns. Good workout here with Gene Murphy and Ken Larmer. About a minute to go. Speaking of popular men like Larmer, I believe we're going to see Tim Gahigan. Look at that, it's a neat maneuver by Murphy. Boy, he's murdering that leg. Now, the Larmer's turn, and Murphy's got the troubles. Murphy can't break it. We're just about out of time. There it is, a very fine workout between Gene Murphy and Ken Larmer. Good round of applause from the crowd, and we'll get somebody in the ring fast-like. Next on the agenda, we have Gino Bob Morella about to go back into the ring. Timothy Gahigan over here at ringside. We'll get up here in the lights, shall we, man? This Murphy did a very nice job in that ring, in that workout, that's for sure. Timmy, are you ready? Two falls out of three. Fine. It's real nice to see you again, as always. What are you going to tell us about now, besides the fact that I hear and I have no doubt that you are the man who could handle Bulldog Brower?
Well, that is up to Mr. Stuart Hart here, and of course, if the demand is great enough. Now, somebody suggested, some people asked me, they said, if we called in, could we force Hart's issue, force the issue on Mr. Stuart Hart? I said, well, I said, it might be a bad idea.
What I would like to do is give the, like, after all, my paying fans are the ones that keep me in business, and I would like to give them a match that they prefer, you know. But I get several views now. If somebody has a suggestion who they would like to see tackle, anybody for that matter, a certain match, I would... I welcome a suggestion, and if I get enough inquiries, I would make that match. Now, right now, I'm contemplating several, but I haven't just made my mind up. But if I get, I have a lot of calls on you, frankly, requesting, because I feel that after what you did to Brower last Saturday in here when you put him away, and then they saw you put Ursus away, and Ursus carried you to right over the top of those seats and everything right out into, and he finally collapsed in the doorway there, fell on his face. Now Ursus got a 24-inch neck.
It's a fantastic.
And he is a vertebral giant, isn't he? He's a real giant.
Oh, yes, absolutely. I think, as a matter of fact, to my mind, it was a demonstration of strength and par excellence. To my mind, this man did a feat of strength which was fantastic. He actually climbed over the back of the seats with me on his back, but of course he finally succumbed because the sleeper hole is definitely a hole that is, gets results. But I am not also limited. Excuse me, Stu, for one moment. I said I am not also limited. I've been featuring this sleeper hole around here and, of course, in Toronto and all over. But I've always kept in the background another hold which I have used with great success over a period of years. As a matter of fact, I developed it after I left the amateurs, and I've used it with great success over the years. It is a little hole that I always fall back in if necessary.
You know, Hurst's end, you reminded me of this movie I saw of the water buffalo and the tiger. The tiger was on the water buffalo's back, you know, trying to... And Mighty Hurst's charged into the wall there trying to knock Timmy off. But he backed up into the wall two or three times, but he could not budge him, and finally he sunk down and went under. But
we're just going to call you the Tiger from now on.
They called Godoy the fighter, you know, who fought Dempsey. I mean,
Archer Godoy.
Who fought Dempsey?
Oh, Purple.
Purple. Yeah, Wild Bull.
Wild Bull of the Pampas. Well, I call, after last night's match, I call him the Wild Bull of the Pecos.
Well, thank you very much, gentlemen. I think we better sneak out of Mr. Morella?
I realize that by this action here this morning, I cannot lose the pot.
because it stipulates that I have to be either pinned or cause a submit in 10 minutes. Now, up to today, I have been given literally passive resistance for the simple fact that in my mind, I know that there's nobody in this crew or in this territory right here now that can cause me to submit or pin me in 10 minutes. But as of today, when I step in that ring next time for that pot, I will have the reverse psychology on the deal. I'm going to say that this man has got the pot, and I'm trying to take it from him. And I'm telling you, the matches won't go 10 minutes.
There is an ultimatum.
There is an ultimatum. Okay, I won't argue with him. Okay, we got Ripper Miller in the ring with Bill Soloweko. Let's go.
How many minutes have we got left here, Ed?
Nine minutes remaining on the show. So we'll have to make this a fairly brief match. Rip Miller, Bill Soloweko, two big men. Good takedown by Soloweko.
Big Bill is smiting a bit over that mauling he got by Bulldog Bauer.
Big Bill didn't get a chance to get started. He got attacked from the rear at the beginning of the fight, pounded around, didn't even get on track, and before he knew it, the fight was over. And Soloweko, as Stu points out, is really smarting from that one. Soloweko, very big man. Former Calgary steelworker. I think he could pound out that steel without a hammer, just do it with his bare hands. He's powerful. Rip Miller, of course, a cousin of the infamous Miller brothers, and he's a big man, too, extremely big, 6'7". Up in that 280-pound class, very big man. So you got, hang on, you got a lot of power in that ring at the present time.
No, not right now.
Rather interested in that outburst by Morella. He's normally a very mild-mannered gentleman, and I guess somebody's rubbing him the wrong way.
See, to bother him getting knocked out of the ring then counted out, you know, because it's the first time he's come close to losing a match since he's been in the territory.
Right. Miller trying to handle this big man.
Come on, Miller! Come on, Miller! Kind of nice in here today without the Bulldog, isn't it?
Well, we're quite happy, actually, you know. It's nice to get a word in edgewise here without that ranting, screaming, raving type of on. Miller applying the pressure here to Soloweko.
My stock in Walder went up a lot last night after I saw him wrestle that Bulldog, because Walder didn't take a thing from the man. He battled him tooth and nail. In fact, Bulldog was taking more than he was giving.
As a matter of fact, Waldo won a lot of friends on the basis of that performance, something I never would have believed, due to the fact that he certainly was not exactly popular in this area. Look out! Oh! Soloweko just looks at him in disdain and says, go away. Boy, oh boy. I'll tell you, being hit by that Miller is somewhat akin to being hit by a freight train, and yet Soloweko stood right up to him.
Big Mighty, I see him over there. He's a little upset about having that 24-inch neck of his bent there with a sleeper hold.
Mighty Ursus, the wild bull of the Pecos. Okay, well, you're going to go just another less than a minute on this match. And we'll wrap things up for today rather quietly due to the fact that Mr. Brower must be away somewhere having his head red, I guess, Stu.
Yeah, he's an unusual character.
That's the understatement of the century. And then, unusual is right. Soloweko and Miller getting just a little bit raspy. Oh, I spoke too soon. No! Arriving with suitcase and all. Well, let's wrap up this match.
Where is this nonsense here? You told me to be here at 11 o'clock. 11 o'clock you told me to be here. what this nonsense? Are you scared that I'm going to kill your boys in the air? Your little baby boys. Your little baby boys. Did you see what I did to all your opponents, all your men here? I killed them. I'll show you how these guys think they're good, huh?
Well, this man is crazy. Dropped his glasses here in my lap. His coat goes down the ring, and away he goes again. Get out of the way, people. Here he comes. Look out. Down he goes, Rip Miller. Down in front of me here, and they're trying to get... We had anticipated he wouldn't be here. Father Winkle's going at him. Slams him in that corner. Goes too hard out of there. Goes after him again. Father Winkle back in. Chases Brown. By Solo Waco. Rip Miller, in the meantime, is down on the concrete. I thought things were under control. I didn't think we were going to have one of these displays, but obviously our friend Brown thinks differently. Still hot trying to control him. He's going into the chairs, and I'm trying to keep my microphone in. Somebody cut our power off. Somebody broke our microphone cord. The place was a panic. I'm back in business again. They put Mr. Brower back in his cage. And I think that's going to wrap it up for this week. The advanced ticket reservations on Friday night. Drop in with you to the Victoria Pavilion or to Daniel's Royal Eye News and give a call to Atlas 30552. And if you think there's somebody in this area who control Bulldog Brower, why not give Stu Hart a call at CH92143. Got that? CH92143. This man is a liberty.
And he is going to conform to our rules or he will not be wrestling here, I'll tell you that. And if I have to take steps to curb him, we'll find ways of curbing him because there's a lot of big men handled. And we can't have one of the rest is handling. We'll have some. If one can't handle, a dozen or two will. And he's just going to settle down, do his wrestling in this ring.
Or else.
Or else.
Well, I don't blame you, Stu. It's quite a display. We're out of time. Don't forget that number for Stu.